I started the previous video by pointing out that there are two main properties of interest when we have a data set in front of us. The first was the center or average value for that set. We looked at that in the previous video, which we called measures of center. In this video, we're going to talk about the second property. Given a data set, how spread out is the data? And we call this video measures of dispersion. The first measure of dispersion is called the range. And the range of a set of data is simply the largest value minus the smallest value. For this set of data, the range is just going to be 50 minus 9. So we get an answer of 41. To get a slightly different visual of the situation, if we graph all of our data values on this number line, the range does give us some measure of how spread out our data is. In other words, it gives us some measure of the variability of the data. Our next measure of dispersion or variability in data is called the standard deviation. And the standard deviation of a data set gives us some idea of how much our data values differ from the mean of the data set. Let me give you a quick visual for a standard deviation. Let's say we have two data sets and they have the same exact mean, but where the values in set one kind of stay close to the mean, the values in set two are a little bit more spread out around the mean. So on average, each data value in set one is closer to the mean than each data value in set two. Therefore, set one has a lower standard deviation than set two. And of course, given some set of data, we're going to want to know how to calculate that standard deviation. So here are our steps. We're going to do an example here in a second. But one more note about notation. As far as the symbols that we use, S is the letter that we use to denote a sample standard deviation. And typically, it's going to be sample standard deviations that we're calculating here. If we know the standard deviation of a population, it would be written as a Greek sigma. And we're going to use that sigma quite a bit in the following section. Okay, so why don't we go ahead and calculate the standard deviation of this set of data right here. The first thing that we're going to do is find the mean of that data. We learned how to do that in the previous video. I'm getting that all of our data values add up to 35. When we divide by the number of data values, which is 5, we get a mean of 7. That is step 1. In the next step, we're going to make a chart with the columns value, value minus mean, and value minus mean squared. And I'm going to leave a little bit of room in this chart because I'm going to use some math symbols in here in a second. But what we're going to do is in our value column, we're going to list all of our data points. Now in the second column, we're going to take each one of those data values and subtract the mean that we just calculated. So for a value of 2, we're going to subtract the mean of 7 that we just calculated, and that's going to give us an answer in this column of negative 5. For a value of 6, we're going to subtract that same mean and get a value in this column of negative 1. We're going to continue that process all the way down this column. In the third column, we're going to take the results that we got from the second column and just square each result. Keep in mind that when you square a negative number, that gives us a positive number. So negative 5 squared is positive 25. We can continue squaring all of our results from the second column. And now we have completed our chart. But before we move on, I want to give you a little bit of notation. Instead of writing out the whole word value for this first column, typically what we'll do is just call this first column x. Then instead of writing out value minus mean for the second column, we will call this x minus x bar. And for the third column, we will just write x minus x bar squared. Okay, so far what we've done is we found the mean, then we made a chart, we completed that chart. Our fourth step is going to be to sum all of the values in our third column. So we're going to do 25 plus 1 plus 2 plus 16 plus 100. I'm getting that all of that adds up to 144. That was our fourth step. Now I'm running out of room here, so I'm going to move this down. Our fifth step says that we need to take that result and divide it by n minus 1. So we're going to take the 144, and we're going to divide that by n minus 1. Well, we had 5 data values here, so our n is 5. In other words, we're taking 144 and we're going to divide that by 4. I'm getting 36 is my answer for step 5. And finally, just squeezing in this last step here, we're going to take the square root of the previous result. So we're going to take the square root of 36, and our final answer is that the standard deviation for that data set is 6. So I'm going to zoom out here so you can see all of those steps. We just calculated a sample standard deviation, so if we wanted to use the appropriate letter here, we would say our final answer was S equals 6. Okay, so for the rest of this video, I just want to do one more calculation. Let's find the standard deviation of this set of data. Our first step is finding the mean. Adding up all those data values, I'm getting 216. And if we divide that by 6, I'm getting 36 as our mean value. Now, I'm going to create a chart. And in this first column, we're going to put all of our data values. In the second column, we're going to subtract the mean that we just calculated from each one of our data values. So I'll go ahead and go through those steps. Okay, now we're going to take the result from the second column and square it and put it in the third column. All right, so we found the mean in step 1. In step 2, we created a chart, and then we filled out that chart for our step 3. Now we're going to add all of the values from the third column for step 4. I'm getting a total of 4,294. For step 5, we're going to take that number, and we're going to divide by n minus 1. Our n value in this case is 6 because we had 6 data values. So we're going to take 4,294 and divide by 5. That gives us a result of 858.8. And for our final step, the value of our standard deviation is going to be the square root of 858.8. I'm getting that to be approximately 29.31. So if you can complete that calculation, you should be pretty set for this section. But one more note about notation before we end this video. In this chart, we used x to represent our data values. We used x minus x bar to represent the difference between our data value and the mean. And in the third column, we squared each of those results. In step 4, we added all of those results together. So the notation for that would be the sum of x minus x bar squared. In the fifth step, what we did is we took that sum that we found in step 4 and we divided that by n minus 1. So that's the notation we would use for step 5. And finally, in this last step, what we did is we took a big square root of that whole result. So we took that whole result from step 5 and we took a square root of that. Now I'm going to move that over. And we call that S, our standard deviation. And that is the formula that you will see in textbooks for the sample standard deviation of some data set. Okay, let's call it there. I will see y'all in the next video.